How's the sound work? Do they need a remote mic or anything?
No. So this is a shotgun mic. So
you want to go ahead and get started?
Great.
And my project specifically assesses the effects of field treatments understory vegetation, especially the dynamics of engagement of non-native plants into these plots. So the site here, the research area, is highlighted on there. It's the Royal Gorge BLM Field Office in between Slide 18. In order to complete this research, I needed to go to 232 point locations throughout the area. And I collected data related to vegetation in order to characterize communities. I used point line intercepts to address vegetation cover. I recorded woodchip pile depth at each intercept on the cover tree effect. And I identified plants to species level for vegetation and community composition. And this is just a basic diagram of what the plot looks like when we get to one of these 232 sites. So, right now, I have completed the field work for these plots, despite challenges such as snow on the first day of field season, and just the logistics involved in getting and as of now, I'm in the very early stages of Bluetooths are surrounded by non-invasive plants, mostly cheatgrass, Russian thistle, and tall timber mustard. So this indicates that maybe these field treatments might not be the most appropriate land management strategy to address these resilience goals. The long-term implications of invasive plants and climate change are, there's a lot of uncertainty involved in it, but they're going to require management. And the goal of future management strategy to address these problems should be so that management strategies are don't require constant intensive human management, but instead enough management so that the ecosystem can still provide ecosystem services and function in the ways that we rely on. So, there's, like I said, there's a lot of uncertainty involved in these, in the future of climate change and invasive plant proliferation and persistence. So there's a lot of additional research needs that we will face in the future, such as the influence of grazing and treatment sites, distance from roads or development, things like that. And we also need to develop science-based recommendations for appropriate land management strategies that would address resiliency goals related to preserving wildlife habitat, wildfire safety goals, and ecosystem services.
How did you do field work in the snow? Were you doing point line intercepts in the snow?
I think that day we actually decided to do the dendroecology stuff. So yeah, we had to go back to those sites. But it was tough at the very beginning of the year. And I had to revisit a few sites to see what actually came up after the snow was gone. So it was definitely a challenge when you're working with the growing system like that.
I didn't really hear, what were the treatment methods you were using?
Hydrax treatments and hand thinning. So Hydrax is a big piece of machinery that just basically mows down huge swaths of trees, and then hand thinning is an individual body and head.
Both non-salvage?
Right.
Are you finding that a chip of plastic materials pressing the growth or advancing it?
You can tell that where these piles are, there's not much coming up. yeah, I would say it's suppressing it, but then it's just surrounded by non-natives, so seems like the non-natives will probably have a better chance of coming back up.
Were they like burning in these last piles?
No.
Have they done any sort of like scrap burns in the area instead of
I believe they have, or I know some of the sites look like they're have items on them, but the spreading
talk a little bit more about some of the management implications and exactly like how you would imagine your work leading to particular changes?
Yeah, I can't say right now that I have an appropriate alternative, but I would hope that this study would at least give land managers some information as far as what, where they should do these treatments, if it's already a really easy area.
expensive. It'd be like $500 or $1,000 for a bag to, you know, throw that out. So I don't know if that has been looked at all. Having DHC is like ready after treatment area is just a...
Yeah, I'm not sure if they've done that on any of these sites. Maybe for the high-rise ones, they might require to put some DHC down, but I don't know if they've done that on any sites. I don't think the Bureau of Land Management is going to have to have the resources to do that for every single site. Any other questions? Thank you.
We have about 3.5 minutes before our chat.